You can win this sporty car with just one answer on Card Sharks. And if you play your cards right, you can win $32,000. And now, the host of Card Sharks, Bob Eubanks.
Thank you. Thank you, Gene Wood. Good morning, everybody, and welcome to Card Sharks. Let me tell you, we're going to get our two contestants out here. We got a new car and lots of money to give away. So, first of all, let's meet our two lovely dealers. Here they are. They're with us every morning. And they are Lacey Pemberton and Susanna Williams, our dealers on Card Sharks.
Hey.
Hey. We're gonna start with a tiebreaker. That means how many cards we deal out?
It's a test, three?
Girls. Oh, good. All right. If you'll deal out the cards, we'll get our two Card Sharks in here. Come on, champ and challenger. Jordan and Beverly.
Hi, Bob.
Hi, Bob.
Nice to have you back with us today. Our champion has won $5,900. Played
for
big money one time. The man from Bulgaria, right?
Correct.
I was learning to speak Bulgarian when we last left.
That's right.
Yes.
And you were doing pretty well, too, Bob, if you don't mind me saying so.
I thought so, too. Go ahead and tell me about Jordan.
My name is Jordan Metodiev. I'm originally from Bulgaria. I have been living here for 20 years in the United States, happily married with two lovely kids.
That's about it. Okay. Was English hard to learn?
Not really.
It's a pretty easy language, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
I mean, when you can say two, three different ways, and there...
Exactly,
Blow your mind away. Hello, Beverly.
Hi, Bob.
Well, you look pretty today.
Thank you, Bob. So do you.
Oh, thank you. Yeah, this is a new suit.
I like your tie.
Thank you. I like it, too, yes.
Oh, yes.
I'm going to take it home with me. Tell me, Bev.
I'm Beverly Coleman. I'm originally from New York City.
Uh-huh.
I'm a lawyer. I've recently left large law firm practice to open up my own practice in Century City.
What kind of law do you specialize in?
Real estate and general corporate.
Well, wonderful. Nice to have you back with us. No, wait, when we left last time, each contestant has won a game. Jordan won the first game and Beverly won the second game or whatever.
Yes.
Anyway, we're going to play a tiebreaker because the rules say that if you win two games, you are a champion, play for the big money and all of that. So if you notice, the girls have dealt out only one, two, three cards. They got it right. And it's a one-game sudden death. So good luck to you, and here we go. Beverly, the question is yours, and all this week in our studio audience, you're going to like this, Bev, we have 10 men who are all business executives. Gentlemen, would you please join us? All right. Thanks for being with us, guys. Now, we always hear rags-to-riches stories from successful people, Beverly. So before the show, we ask these 10 executives, did you work your way up from the mailroom? How many of these 10 executives did work their way up from the mailroom?
Oh, 10 handsome executives. I'm single, by the way, Bob.
Sure.
Looking for a husband.
I imagine there's a lot of husbands down there.
Well, starting, I suspect that a lot of them, there are a lot of places to start, but specifically in the mailroom, I think that's going to be a small number. Two
of them. Let's see what Jordan says.
I have to say, by saying in the mailroom, that does not necessarily mean that they literally started from the mailroom.
There's no female room. Where the heck would they start?
That's right. I will have to say
this
Bob Tyre.
This is M-A-I-L, Jordan.
M-A-I-L?
Yeah, not M-A-L-E. You know, that's the problem that we have with this language. All
male.
Right. The actual number of these executives who worked their way up from the mailroom is 4 of them.
Yeah!
Yeah! Which four of you guys worked your way up from the mailroom, if you would please? No kidding. Bowden did. And Mike Glickman, you worked your way up from the mailroom.
Yes, I did. I started delivering flyers for real estate companies 13 years ago. I got my real estate license, and today I own the fourth largest real estate company in the western United States.
Yes, you do it. Yeah, it's true. Thank you, Mike. Nice to have you with us. And you can't go anywhere in Southern California without seeing his signs. I thought he was missing. You know, the guy keeps saying, Mike, but I guess he's here now. All right, who's got all this control?
Jordan does.
Jordan, I'll show you your base card. I'll show you Beverly's base card. You have a decision to make at that time. All right, Jordan, your base card happens to be a 5. Beverly's base card is a queen. Now, you can play it out. If you make a mistake, she's the champ, or you can pass it on to her. If she goofs, you're the champ.
I will change the card, please, and play it.
Well, change the five.
Yes,
change
sir.
The five and play it. All right, good luck to you. There, you got a 10.
Lower, Bob.
Lower than the 10. No! Beverly, you're on it. Okay. Well, Jordan, you end up with $5,900. Thanks for being with us, my friend.
Thank you very
nice,
much.
Man. We'll see you again. Come on, Bev. Right over here, sweetie. All right. So we've got a new champ. When we come back, we can give our new champ a chance to win lots of money and a brand new car. We'll be right back with that.
All right.
Sensitive skin.
Welcome back to Card Sharks. All right, champ, let me tell you a little bit about this. You can change one card per line. That's really an important rule for you. And the minimum bets are $50 each time. Nice thing about this, you're playing with our money. And we're going to give you $200. You got it. Good luck to you, sweetie. Here we go.
Thank you.
Have fun. This is it. Chance to win a lot of money. And your first card turns out to be a three. $200.
All of it higher.
Yeah, let's go for the gusto. Now you got $400. Play your change.
$300 higher.
You want to change the six? You'll keep the six, right?
I'm going to keep that
okay,
six.
Okay, and go $300 higher than the six. No. Back
but it's $100. Okay. Okay. All of it higher.
Gonna bet it all higher than the four. Let's see if it is. Yeah, it is. Now you're up to $200 up here. Give you another four. You got $600.
We're going to change that eight. Two.
Change those cards. That's the important thing here. All right. The eight becomes a jack. You've got $600.
$400 lower.
$400 lower than the jack. Whoa.
Oh.
Back to $200.
All of it higher.
No, not higher.
Excuse me, all lower than lower.
Yeah, girl. We'll bet it all lower than the A's. Now.
All of it higher.
Now we'll bet it all higher than the deuce. Oops. Push. No win, no loss. That's okay. You can still win $800 here.
Well, what should I bet? All of it higher.
Try all of it higher again, is it? Yeah. There you are. Okay, $800. I wanted you to change that six.
I know you did.
Dirty, rotten old sixes. Okay, you've got $1,000 now. Now we're going to give you a chance to win a brand new car. And if you'll come with me, Gene's going to tell you about the car you can win. Do you know?
Presenting the new Suzuki Sidekick. Contemporary styling with a tough, rugged, and gutsy performance. Comes equipped with standard features and California emission. Good luck, Beverly.
Okay, Beverly. Now, here's how you can win that neat little car there.
Gene told us about.
Pretty easy to do. I'm going to ask you a question about our 10 business executives down there. Then we'll ask you to go over there and register your answer on our range board. So, Lacey, you have the question, hon?
There you go.
Thank you. Recently, Donald Trump said that he enjoyed working more than taking a vacation. So, before the show, we ask our 10 executives down there, would you rather work than take a vacation? How many of these 10 executives would rather work than take a vacation? I want you to go over there and place the marker on your answer. I let her read the card because there's no answer on it. How many do you think? How many would rather work than take a vacation? She said 7 of the 10. If you're right, if it is 7, you win the car. If you're off by 1, if it's 6 or 8, you win another $500. Well, the actual number of these executives who would rather work than take a vacation is
4 of them.
I thought it'd be higher than that. That's all right. You got $1,000. You're our champion. We'll meet a new challenger when we come back right after this. Don't go away.
It's the...
Welcome back to Card Sharks. Well, Beverly, you got $1,000. It's time
sure
to do challenges. So come on, Joe, join us on Card Sharks.
Woo-hoo! Hey, Joe. How you doing?
Have we ever met before? We have not, right?
I don't believe so.
Okay, let me guess. You're from New York.
Close.
Where?
Detroit.
Oh, that's not close. I would have bet my next week's salary on that he was from New York.
I've got one of those faces.
Tell me about Joe.
Hi, Bob. I'm originally from Clarksburg, West Virginia. A family of 7 Italians, 3 brothers, 3 sisters. Had a grandfather who lived 108. I have a great aunt and uncle who had 75 years of marriage life. I'm presently married and have 3 children. And...
Your great uncle's married and has 3 children?
No, I'm presently married and have 3 children. And my wife's brother has done 2 of the Iron Men.
That's about, actually, that's a little more than we really wanted to know about.
I thought I embarrassed my wife.
He told us about all of his family. Let's go and play this game. If you win 2 games, you're our champion. We won't have to hear about your damn relatives anymore. So let's get it going. I've got a question for you, Beverly. Beverly, Vice President Dan Quayle revealed that his wife insisted on wearing a hat to the inauguration, even though he told her that he didn't like it. So we surveyed 100 married women, and we asked them, if your husband told you he hated your outfit, would you wear it anyway? How many married women would wear the outfit?
Oh, golly.
I tend to like to dress. I dress for me. But I wouldn't
Some
wear...
of the guys out there think you're dressing for them.
Well, I was going to say, I tend to like to please the person that I'm with, and I like them to like what I have on and to show their appreciation and stop there. And I would change
would
my outfit. I would definitely
you
change.
Would.
If he really hated it, I'd change my outfit. And I think that I'm, you know, a fairly liberated woman.
So how many out of 100?
35.
I think married women would wear the outfit.
Even though their husband hated it.
Yeah.
35.
35 out of 100 would wear the outfit even though her husband hated it. Joe?
Well, Bob, my wife has a problem with me.
I can imagine that.
You see, if she tells me to change, I don't mind changing. But when I go to get the hanger to put something like back on, the hanger's gone out of the closet. She's the kind that will not let a hanger lay in there. But if I want to change, I'll change. You know, does that make sense to you, Bob?
Higher or lower than 35, Joe? I don't care about your dirty clothes.
I think Quail's got a problem with a hat. So I'll go lower.
Lower, thank you. The actual number of married women who would wear an outfit their husband hated is 34 of them. You're right, it wasn't a lot. You're off by one, Debbie.
I was totally lost in that question.
If your guy hated your outfit, would you not wear it?
I would probably change it.
You'd
yeah,
change it?
Yeah, just avoid the argument.
Go change that outfit. Here we go, 10.
Oh. Let's change that card.
Change that card.
Yay.
All right, the 10 now becomes a 9.
A big deal. About a little lower.
Lower than the 9, no. Beverly gets a free chance. Beverly, for you, I have a king.
Oh, lower, Bob.
Lower than the king, 10.
Lower, Bob.
Lower than the 10, 8.
Freeze, Bob.
Freeze on the 08. Sure, don't blame you. All right. So we'll try another question. This is for you, Joe. It's an educated guess question. I'm sure you'll know a lot about this, my friend. How many pounds is the heaviest weight anyone ever lifted off the floor with his teeth?
With his teeth?
Same thing I said
Same
to you, Joe.
Same thing you said a minute ago.
How many pounds?
Oh, by watching a lot of the Olympics, I don't think I've seen anything like that with their teeth. But an educated guess, I could say about 400.
400 pounds with the teeth. Beverly, higher or lower than that?
Yes, Higher.
The heaviest weight anyone has ever lifted off the floor with their teeth is, you ready for this one, folks? 606 pounds. Yeah.
The guys with the, they pull the trains with their teeth.
Yeah, you know what it was, though? It was in New Mexico. Some guy lifted a 606-pound pumpkin off the ground with his teeth. Isn't that interesting? You can tell everybody at the cocktail party tonight about that one, folks. All right, Beverly, want to change this 8?
Let's change that card, Bob.
We'll do it. Thank you. Susanna, now you got a 9.
Oh, that's a wonderful lower, Bob.
Lower than a 9 for.
Higher, Bob.
To win the game, if it's higher, you bet it is. Sure.
I've learned something about 9s.
All right. So, Beverly wins the first game, and we're going to set up now for game number 2. Joe, you know you have to win this game now
right
to stay
on
in this little number. Susanna will deal out the cards in the same deck, and here we go. First question's for you, Bev. We surveyed 100 college men who belong to a fraternity, and we asked them, have you ever gone on a panty raid? They still have those.
So I've heard.
How many fraternity men said they have? They've gone on a panty raid.
Well, it's been a number of years since I've been in college.
You ever been on a panty raid?
No, and I was never raided.
Sorry. Probably not as sorry as you are, but I'm sorry.
Moving right along. How many guys have been on a panty raid? I think a lot of them probably have. It's a tradition. It's 72.
72. Let's check with the expert, Joe.
Well, being an expert on this matter, you know, I would certainly have to say lower because... nowadays, it isn't as predominant as it used to be. They've outlawed it, more or less. I've definitely got to go lower.
I'm glad we have somebody here who knows the law.
Sure.
The actual number of fraternity men who have gone on a panty raid is 77 of them. Woo! I didn't know they had those things anymore.
Surprised me.
Long time ago. It's Beverly, right?
Yes,
okay, Bev, take a look. 8.
Let's change that card.
Yeah, 8 becomes now a 5.
Higher, Bob.
Higher than the 5 is a 9.
Lower, Bob.
Lower is a king.
All right.
I mean, Joe, you get a free opportunity to practice your higher or lower here, Joe. There's a J.
Okay, let's go lower.
Lower it is. it is again.
Higher!
Higher than a four. No. Oh. He went against the odds, and he went with the odds, and he got whacked down. Okay. We'll pause. We'll be right back. Don't go away.
I'm sorry you didn't get it. I thought you were going to kill
him. Welcome back to Card Sharks. All right, let's continue with this game now. Joe, I've got a question for you.
Okay.
How'd you get to be so silly?
I don't know.
Make a living selling you walnuts, you know that?
Yeah, I'd probably store them too.
Joe, this question has to do with our 10 business executives who are in our studio audience. Now, before the show, we asked these 10 executives, would you like to live in a world where the roles were reversed and men stayed home to have the babies while women went out to work? How many of these 10 executives would like it if men and women actually reversed their roles?
Well, Bob, I'll tell you, I don't think any of those guys are going to have that capability. None of them.
Yeah, that's a foregone conclusion, Joe. We know they don't have the capability.
When my wife had her baby, I saw everything was right, and I had to go bowling that night. So, I mean, it was just a case of getting out of there.
Sure, I understand.
You understand that? I don't think that, I don't think
it's not that
two
hard.
Of them would even consider that.
Is that your answer, two?
Two.
Thank you. Beverly, higher or lower than two?
Two of them would consider?
Yeah, he says two of the 10 would like it if men's and women's roles were reversed.
I think it's higher.
I think it's higher than that. Actual number of these executives who would like it if men's and women's roles were reversed is three of them. You're right, Beverly. It was a little higher.
Finally.
Change those diapers every day, guys. I don't know. Raise your hand. Which three of you would like to switch the roles? Mr. Bowden. And who else here? Raise your hand. And Mr. Duff. And Jim Holiday. You would like to actually change?
Yeah, I got three great kids. I really don't mind housework that much. And I've played Mr. Mom before, and I liked it.
You liked it. Now, your last name is Holiday. You're not in the hotel business, are you, sir?
No.
No, okay. But you'd really like to stay home and take care of those
sure.
little people.
Sure.
Darn. Okay, to each his own. Thank you, gentlemen, very much for sharing your story with us. Here we go. Beverly, well, keep the five or change the five?
I'm going to keep that five, Bob.
Okay, here we go.
Let's go higher.
Higher than the five is a jack.
Lower, Bob.
Lower than that jack is a deuce.
Higher.
Look out now, Jack.
Lower.
If it's lower, you win the game. You're the champ again. You'll play for the big money and a new car. Lower than the jack? Yes, it is. Bingo. The lady got you, Joe. Thanks, Joe, for being with us. We have nice prizes
Thank
for you.
You.
Delightful guy. We'll see you again.
You.
Come on, Beverly. Right over here, my dear. All right. Good for you. Well, okay. Now the lady's going to have another opportunity. Had a little bad luck last time we played for the big
nice
money.
Cards,
yeah, you're
Bob.
Now up to $1,200, though. And the ladies are going to start dealing out cards from a deck that you cut a little earlier on. Let's remind everybody again, you can change one card per line. Minimum bets are $50 each time. And the nice thing about it is you're playing with our money. So give the lady $200, and here we go. Good luck to you, Beverly. All right. First card, Bev. With the $200, you now have an ace. How's that?
I think we'll go all the way lower.
All the way lower than the ace. Now you have a 10, $400. Player change.
I'm going to change it.
Which one?
Which number?
One. Number one. She'll change the 10 and see what we have. 10 becomes a 7.
Wonderful.
Now you got $400, Beverly.
$200 high. Well, $50 higher.
$50 higher than the 7. It is not. You're back to $350.
$300 higher.
$300 higher than the 7. Yes, it is.
Great.
Now you got $650. Up here, another 4. You got $1,050.
$1,000 lower.
$1,000 lower than the queen. Yeah. $2,050. Player change.
I'm going to change the card to 3.
Number 3. Let's have a good card, Lace. The 10 now becomes a queen. A little better. $2,050.
$1,000 lower.
$1,000 lower than the queen. Push. No win, no loss.
$1,000 lower.
Same bet, the lady says. $1,000 lower than the queen. Deuce. There you go. Can you smell the money, huh?
All okay. of it higher.
Sure, it's going to be worth about $6,100 to you. Yes. Isn't that nice? $6,100 added to what you had. You're now at $7,300 in cash. And we'll be back in just a moment with our champion right after this. the time we have for today. We're going to pick up our next show with you having a chance to win the new car, okay? So you kind of get nervous until the next show. It's all the time we have for today. For Lacey Pemberton, Susanna Williams, Gene Wood and the gang, I'm Bob Eubanks saying thank you very much. And thanks to our 10 businessmen. They'll be with us all week long. It's going to be very interesting having them with us, too. So long, everybody. Till next time from all of us at Card Sharks. Bye-bye.
How far would you go to win Olympic gold?
Nothing would stop Tonya Harding. Nothing.
How far to win an election?
I will support the Constitution of the United States.
How far to win the trial of the century?
If it doesn't fit, you must acquit.
Anything to Win, the new documentary series about people who refuse to lose. This week, the MIT Blackjack team exposed.
Right as we speak, there's an MIT team playing in Vegas.
Anything to Win, Tuesday at 9, 8 Central, only on GSN.